Welcome to our Metal 3D Printing Applications and Design Best Practices webinar with Markforged. My name is Saratech with Saratech, and I am your host. Our special guest today is Markforged Application Engineer John Bannon. Now, I'd like to pass it over to John.
All right, great. Well, thank you very much, Sarah, for that great introduction, and welcome everyone to today's webinar. I'm really excited to be here. And today we're going to be focusing on unlocking innovation in design and manufacturing with metal printing. So just a little bit about myself. I'm a mechanical engineer, and my focus is working with partners and companies that are interested in exploring their applications for metal 3D printing in plastics, composites, and metals. So the goal today is ultimately to help you understand how other customers have utilized Markforged Metal X printers, where solutions can be unlocked, and who additive manufacturing matters to most, and why it should matter to you. So to start off, we're going to jump into a production use case. We'll transition into DFAM for that use case. We'll talk about AM initiatives and search strategies for your organization. Then we're going to look at some customer applications and industries using additive and metal, dive into some metal materials and our technology stack, as well as talk about digital transformation and end with a Markforged use case and some Markforged updates. So let's go ahead and begin. So the first customer case that we want to jump into is what we have on the screen here. This picture shows some end effectors grippers from our customer Lean Machine. These grippers were 3D printed in metal on our Metal X. So they have this robot arm that they use to transfer a specific sheet metal part from a tray to a press brake to a receptacle where it gets passed off onto the next stage of the process. And this is repeated with exacting precision several hundred times per day. The parts themselves have this slightly curved surface at the very tip that gives clearance for the press brake and still maintains a good grip on the part. And since the sheet metal parts they're handling are steel, the part needs to be highly wear resistant because it's moving so many parts per day. We're also, when we're looking at part like this, we're looking at the tip of the gripper jaws because it'll experience the most wear. So the wear resistance plus the curvature of the tip is why we printed it out of stainless steel. It would have taken a really long time for this particular part to be machined manually, and it would cost a lot as well. So when we're looking at this part, apart from the wear resistance, what other properties do we need? Well, the first thing we need is strength and stiffness. We want to hold the part securely and minimize deflections when clamping. This part also needs to be as light as possible to minimize wear of the repeated robot arm actions. So weight here is critically important. One gripper weighs in at 156 grams. And we saved weight with this design because we printed with the default infill geometry instead of a solid metal part. So a traditional steel part would have weighed two or three times as much had it been machined. So this robot arm can use this new lighter gripper so it can move faster, which provides higher throughput and puts less strain on the robot arm, which results in less robot maintenance and less overall robot costs. So while this print has had significance in production, Markforged was able to help Lean Machine even realize greater benefits of part optimization for additive using Markforged printers. So what if I told you that we could cut the weight down of this part by as much as another 50% while still maintaining all of these metal properties? And we can do this with what's called a hybrid part. So we take the time to explore the application further to understand where the part needs to be metal and to isolate that segment of the gripper. And then we understand the robot actions, the forces and the loads, so that we can develop another part based out of onyx reinforced with carbon fiber. So our onyx is our base plastic material. It's a nylon 6 with a short strand chopped carbon fiber that we reinforce with continuous strands of carbon fiber. And we have a patented process called CFF, or continuous filament fabrication, where we lay down continuous strands of high strength composite fibers like carbon fiber in an FFF onyx, providing aluminum strength, 60-61 tensile strength, and stiffness to the part. So ultimately, we're able to combine metal and composites together to provide the strength, stiffness, and lightweight characteristics while still exceeding the overall performance of the customer's requirements. So the metal parts initially saved on cost compared to traditional manufacturing, and we saved an additional $20 per part by moving to a hybrid model. That's significant. And you can see the part stats on the bottom graph here that represent both the metal tip and the composite base. So we're saving on cost, we're saving on weight, you're isolating the properties that matter and assigning them to materials that make the most sense for that particular component. And you can print these parts in parallel since they print on different machines. And if you're interested in understanding more about hybrid parts, Markforged is going to have an upcoming metal and assemblies webinar that you can learn more. So let's take a look at DFAM for this case study. So when I say DFAM, I'm referring to the short term for design for additive manufacturing. So this is a term you'll hear extensively as you start exploring 3D printing. So when you're designing for CNC, forging, casting, injection molding, you're designing for a process, and there are parameters that matter on the design side that are critical to its success. Well, the same with 3D printing. You have to understand the capabilities of the tools and how to design for those tools to achieve successful printed parts. So because Markforged relies on automation to build parts, the parameters that matter most are in regards to the design, optimization of the part, orientation of the part on the build plate, and understanding how the material will print so that you can effectively design for tools without trial and error. So Markforged has developed DFAM guides for both composites and metal. Showcased here on the screen, we have the Metal X design guide. And this serves as a recommendation towards helping users design successful metal parts. So you can use this for things like, you know, what's the very minimum part dimensions that I can print on a metal printer? What are the minimum hole and post dimensions, as well as, you know, minimum engraved and embossed features? It also provides important information on maximum unsupported overhangs. So it's important because supports are necessary to prevent overhang collapse during printing and sintering. And it's also considering where your parts will require supports and how you minimize supports to decrease print time, but also ensuring that your supports are easy to access and remove before you print. If not, you need to consider modifying the overhangs or changing your designs to improve support removal. And we give you a number of different considerations. And I'm not going through the entirety of those considerations, but this is available for you today if you want to download it in order to get a more familiarization with how to design for a Metal X 3D printer. So let's take a look at the DFAM design considerations for this specific part. So based on the case study we just looked at, it's an end effector, essentially a gripper, that's used on a robot arm to load and unload and move parts to other processes. So this one part is symmetrical, which means that it's one design for two parts. The part has this slightly curved surface at the tip to give clearance for the press brake and still maintain a good grip on the part. And the part's optimized angle is triangular cutout towards the bottom of the part. There are some embossed features, there's some chamfers, holes and areas that require supports. So if we take this design into consideration and then look at this from a design for additive perspective, we can point out the different characteristics for this particular part. The first one is the overhang angles. Lean Machine did a really good job of keeping their angles to 45 degrees or more. 45 degree angles or greater from the build plate don't require supports. So an overhang feature is a feature that has no material beneath it. And any overhang angle refers to the angle between the horizontal build plate and an overhang feature. So printed overhangs may break off due to gravity, so the model should really be rotated or supported, or support should be used. The next one is the triangular cutout towards the bottom of the shape that represents a well-balanced feature. You can see from the left graphic next to the two that we have an area that's leaning that might fall over, and it might fall over in during sintering because the heat induces a clay-like state as it's sintering. It makes the part malleable. And if the part's not supported, the part could fall over or collapse. So you need to ensure that your geometry is stable in the printed orientation. You want to avoid top-heavy, cantilevered, or tall and thin features to avoid any parts from falling over as it goes through that sintering process. So although the part is shown upright here, you're going to really print this part on its left side to maximize bed contact. Greater the surface area on the print bed minimizes supports and improves bed adhesion. The left side of the part down doesn't have any features, which makes it an ideal face to print on. The length and cutout have critical dimensions. 3D printers have higher precision and planes parallel to the build plate. And small chamfers. So we added chamfers to both sides to maintain symmetry of the part. The bottom edge of your part may splay out during sintering. So adding a half to a millimeter chamfer to the bottom edge of your part will prevent splayed edges, especially on small features like holes and channels. And finally, we machine batch process the parts to be printed. So the more you can pack into a sintering run, the lower cost batch you have per part. So these are a few of the DFAM design considerations that Lean Machine took into account in order to design a successful 3D printed part. So specifically in regards to number three from the previous slide, maximizing bed contact. This becomes especially important using our Eiger software, which is our slicing and configuration tool. As you orient the part differently, the part will print differently. In our case, the part is oriented on its left side so that you can see the part details highlighted in orange on the left. So Eiger provides all the details, the print time, the wash time, the material cost, which includes raft material, support material, and part material. So if you oriented the part upright, you have more to think about than just sagging and unsupported parts. The height of the part, now highlighted in red, indicates that the part is outside the boundary of the center one furnace. So you would have to either reorient the part or change to a larger center, which is our center two, which has a larger center volume, which would allow for this part to be printed in this orientation. But for this example, we went ahead and printed the part on its left side to maximize bed contact. There's one thing that you might notice in this particular orientation where there's no rafts and supports aren't visible from this particular part view. Well, Eiger allows you to actually go in and see the internal geometry of the part and how the part is going to be sliced and what are the internal constituents of the part itself. So by clicking the internal view that's highlighted in orange below the save button, we can actually look at the part and how it's being built layer by layer. And this is all based on the orientation that you select when you orient your part in Eiger. So here we start off with a raft and we build up layer by layer, including the supports and the release material. The raft that we initially print ensures the part shrinks uniformly to its nominal dimensions and center. So let's recap some of the benefits of metal printing so far. So the first benefit is geometric freedom. With metal 3D printing, complexity is free, and additive process creates overhangs and intricate assemblies with no more effort than simple shapes. So parts that are previously required complicated machine setup or excessive material removal can now be produced layer by layer with little effort. The second benefit is no tooling required. 3D printed parts require no fixturing or tooling, and this allows fabricators to create parts with minimal overhead, decreasing part costs for low production. And in addition, the lack of tooling costs enables businesses to take on new jobs where tooling would have been cost prohibitive. And another benefit is automation. Metal 3D printers automatically produce parts from design files, so no CAM is necessary. Eiger, Markforged 3D printing software, processes the file with minimal human input. And this helps parts get to customers faster and more affordably than processing it traditionally with a skilled laborer. So let's talk a little bit about where in your organization does 3D printing additive manufacturing fit? Well, there are usually two areas. The first area is a direct impact area. And this usually is where many companies have an R&D department, an innovations lab or initiative where they'll learn about new technology and they'll use that to explore which technologies exist today and which technologies can have significant influence and impact on their business tomorrow and in the next 5 to 10 years. Success in R&D is usually quickly adopted by engineering, manufacturing, product development, quality assurance and quality control, and even maintenance, especially on machines that may require customized tools. And when companies start adopting additive manufacturing, influence and investment shifts because of how successful the technology is transforming their organization. Companies start seeing a faster return on investment and more competitive advantages throughout their organization in departments like operations, supply chain, material planning, marketing, and even customer service. So there are benefits to each of these departments within your organization for additive. So let's take a look at some examples of where customers have used metal 3D printing today. So in this case, we're looking at a press brake. So while these components look relatively simple, each one of these has a lead time of 6 to 8 weeks with traditional manufacturing. That's a long time to wait, considering you can print that and have it next day. Customized stamping, punch and die. These can be printed in less than 12 hours and are ready to use. We also have hardened nozzle components with intricate internal features where added complexity requires no additional setup or tooling. And we have tapping fixtures. This is a hybrid part using composite work holding to align and support a printed metal part that requires a post-processing technique like tapping. And we have an assortment of other components, brackets, inserts, cutting dies. And the print time for each one of these is highly dependent. But each of these prints has a significant value or ROI to the customer and offers unique and flexible capabilities over traditional manufacturing or in addition to the traditional manufacturing you have. So let's talk about some examples in the industries. So Markforged really is at the heart of manufacturers across all industries developing parts based on customers' exacting requirements. So in aerospace, printed metal parts for engine components, printed composite parts for light, weight, and strength. And we have additional materials like Onyx FR. Onyx FR is a flame retardant plastic. It's UL 94V0 rated to be self-extinguishing within 10 seconds. That material can go inside an aircraft. In automotive, we have metal and composite parts keeping production lines up and running. Also printed parts for interior and exterior components of cars. In defense, we have composite and metal printed components for equipment on vehicles and for soldiers in the field. In energy, we have printed metal parts and composite for production lines, service, maintenance, and technical tools. In electronics, or in consumers, we have printed composites and metal for product design, for service bureaus, and developers that are just selling things on Etsy. You know, creativity and innovation knows no bounds. In electronics, we have metal and composite materials like Onyx FR and Onyx ESD to print enclosures for sensitive electronics equipment. In medical, we print composite and medical metal for surgical tools and instruments, and maybe one day for implants. And in heavy industry, we print composites and metal for production lines, equipment, services, tools, gauges. These are what our existing customers are using Markforged today across their organization. And this is really just the start. So let's explore a few strategies that we use to help clients find great 3D printing applications for manufacturing that you can use in your organization today. So don't think of these too rigidly, but you can think of these from your operations for multiple perspectives on how to find different applications. So the first one is looking at the pain points and the cost drivers. These are the inefficiencies of your areas in manufacturing operations that keep you up at night. Like, what does it cost now? This is usually easy to quantify to understand a rapid return on investment for an application. What's the unplanned downtime? How to make the manufacturing environment more efficient, line changeovers, CapEx avoidance, equipment upgrades. These are all areas where there could be applications to explore. And then who in your company might you ask to help with exploring how additive can have an effect? Well, this ranges from your management in manufacturing, production and maintenance teams who have a good handle on costs, to your machine operators who should know where the processes are going wrong and what might contribute to fixing that area. Next, we have manufacturing applications, and there's a lot to unpack here, so I'm just going to touch on a few. So we have things like machine setup, calibration jigs, repairing parts, and maintenance tools. And on the fixturing and tooling side, we're looking at things like soft jaws, work holding, assembly and fixtures, and any other alignment device. And on the line optimization side, these are areas of 3D printed brackets for upgrades and improvements. So your resident experts here are going to be much more on the engineering side, on your production, manufacturing, or maintenance teams, as well as your inspection room or quality manager. And another area are common tooling and fixture materials. We generally see that Markforged can replace traditional parts made from common engineering metals and plastics. So on the metal side, this includes replacing aluminum, tool steels, stainless steels, and carbide. And on the plastic side, includes common engineering plastics like UHMW, or ultra-high molecular weight polyethylene, Delrin, nylons, Teflon. There's so many different materials that Markforged printers can replace to help you with additive and help your manufacturing organization. And the resident experts that you're going to ask potentially are going to be with your production team, your manufacturing, or your maintenance engineers. So there's a walking the line presentation that I presented back in May for Saratech that's available on their YouTube page that dives in a little deeper if you want to explore looking for strategies within your organization further. Well, let's take a look at some metal applications that can be replaced with 3D printed parts instead of traditional manufacturing. So here are several more applications. And the benefits of metal 3D printing inform which types of parts should be printed and which should be fabricated using other methods. So printing parts leverages the advantages of process and allows you to get the most out of your cycle. A complex prototype are great applications because they require geometric complexity and fast single part, low volume turnaround times. So this first one replaces expensive CNC operations. It's for the medical industry, specifically for orthopedic surgeons to practice with new tools. And the reason is because the part's complex geometry makes it expensive and difficult to machine. Here's another application that eliminates the need for prototype tooling in the casting industry. So reduces several week-long lead time processing to print complex casted parts in a matter of days. Get your production lines up and running faster in the valve and metal industry. This is Dixon Valve, and we've used them in a number of different case studies at Markforged, but they're utilizing 3D metal printed gripper jaws, which can withstand significant wear and be conformal to the shape of the valve. We have easy to swap insert tooling for custom metal industry, utilizing a combination hybrid part for tooling with both composites reinforced with carbon fiber and metal tool inserts. We also have fabricating completely custom tools that no one's thought of before in the tooling industry. So low volume, customized, special geometries. In this case, it's a tamper-proof hardware used for military vehicles and wheel locks on sports cars. So all kinds of creativity. You can build your own unique geometries for the robotics industry. Here, there's an intricate design to position a sensor, and this particular component is just not feasible to machine. And we also have replacement of low volume cast parts in the casting industry again. So something like this replaces legacy parts that no longer are in production with no original tooling and no engineering drawings. You can use a combination of 3D scanning and 3D printing to limit the expense of reverse engineering. If you want to explore these geometries and further explore the companies that are doing this, we have a white paper that's available for download at the end of the presentation if you want more information. So while we've explored some applications, there are other companies that are changing their processes to support manufacturing. And those primarily are our investors. But Siemens is a Markforged investor and is heavily investing in Markforged as a revolutionary leap forward in the manufacturing process with what it can do with composites and metal. Markforged is used across several branches of the United States military. In this picture, the US Marine Corps is watching their parts take shape on an X-7 in a base in Afghanistan. Porsche and Volkswagen also have our Markforged investors, and they use Markforged printers for a combination of printed parts to support their manufacturing environment. Now, this manufacturer, a car is produced about every 12.3 seconds. And Markforged printers keep these production lines up and going with no downtime. And what's the major benefit across all of these industries with printing parts like this? It's process. The major benefit is a reduction of time by streamlining manufacturing process and efficiency. So many organizations probably have a really similar or much more complex process than this in order to go from design to product. And this is something that you might be familiar with. And with internal additive manufacturing capabilities, this new process becomes the value driver among departments across your organization. Imagine a process within your organization that could be this short and simplified. Well, Markforged and Saratech can help you realize these capabilities using Markforged 3D printers. We can help you with design for additive and help you with education you need for additive manufacturing. So let's talk a little bit about the materials and the technology that will allow you to do this today. So we have a number of different Markforged metals. The three on your screen represent the three materials that we can print with today. The first one is a 17-4 pH stainless steel. It's a martinestick precipitation hardened stainless steel. It has really great high strength, good corrosion resistance, and it's widely used primarily in the aerospace, medical, and the petroleum industries. We used it to make our assembly fixtures and tooling for our industrial series 3D printers. We also have H13 tool steel. It's a material optimized for high temperature and wear applications, and it's used for molds, die cast, wear inserts, tooling, forming punches and dies. And when heat treated, you can reach a Rockwell hardness between 46 and 50 and an ultimate tensile strength of about 1500 megapascals. So with every material that's released to the public for printing, we have a data sheet that goes with it so that you can see all the characteristics, all the ASTM criteria and tests and certifications that we have for each material. And these data sheets are available today. They're part of the download that you can download at the end of the presentation. We also have A2, which is a tool steel, and it's a cold working tool steel, meaning that metal forming and shaping without the application of heat. So with similar applications of punches, dies, you can do other things like coining, mandrels, and even knurling tools. And while this is, you know, a great start, we're also developing five additional materials. So the first one is D2, which is really very interchangeable with A2 for the most part. But D2 is air-hardened tool steel with high carbon and chromium content. D2 trades toughness for great hardness and abrasion resistance. It's often used for cutting tools and dies, so think knives and multi-tools. But it keeps a very sharp edge for a much longer period of time than A2 does. We also are coming out with copper, so known for its high thermal and electrical conductivity, ductility, and machinability. It's widely used in heat exchangers and electrical for all kinds of different applications. We also have 316L stainless steel, also known as marine grade stainless steel. Exhibits very good corrosion resistance and excellent weldability. Inconel 625. Inconel's strength combined with its impressive heat resistance makes it ideal for heat and pressure shielding. It is considered a super alloy used in marine and industrial applications, and it's very hard and difficult to machine. So it's very easy to print. And the most sought after material that people want is titanium 6-4, also known as grade 5 titanium, ideal for lightweight applications requiring high tensile strength and corrosion resistance. And it's widely used in aerospace applications such as airframe components and jet engines. And there's usually a material that you connect with most. So you have to imagine the possibilities. What innovation does metal 3D printing unlock for you and your organization? So Markforged is the only company that offers a full technology stack industrial 3D printing platform. So we have the software called Eiger. It's built in data and fleet management, slicing and configuration tools. We also have the printers, metal, composite, plastic, and the materials. We talked a little bit about the metal. We also have a series of plastic materials as well. And these are all designed together to provide a seamless user experience, resulting in an incredibly easy-to-use solution with the highest quality parts. So it's a total solution platform to unlock innovation in manufacturing. And today we're primarily talking about the Metal X 3D system, 3D printing platform. It's safe, cost-effective, easy to use, and all which dramatically reduces the lead time, reduces the cost, and maximizes gains across your organization. So on the left, we have the Metal X printers. The silver unit in the middle-ish is our wash station. And on the right, we have our new Sinter 2 that started shipping on August 4th. Offers a larger build volume so that you can get to a point where you can do medium to high quantity, high volume parts. So these are the Metal X specs. And usually most people are interested in the build volume. The Metal X system is up to 90% less expensive than alternative manufacturing additive technologies and 95% faster and cheaper than traditional fabrication techniques like machining or casting. So we use a powder metal that is bound in a wax and a polymer. And the spools that are in use are stored in a temperature controlled chamber that's above the build plate that feeds into the print head from the top. So here we have the metal spool is on the left, and this prints your parts, your rafts, and your support material. And the ceramic spool on the right, this prints your ceramic. And the ceramic is used to separate the parts from the raft and the supports. So this the video is sped up to show how the Metal X printer prints with a raft to ensure uniformity shrinkage in the furnace. We're also showing some white ceramic. There's a white line in the video that provides separation between the supports, the part, and the raft. After sinter, you would simply break the brittle ceramic with your hand or tap with a hammer to remove the part from the support and the raft. So the ceramic itself is pretty interesting because it has a 400 degree delta above the highest temperature the sinter can get to, which ensures that the ceramic remains brittle and easy to separate from the part, raft, and its supports. So what this does for customers is that it allows users to simply literally break the parts off. You don't need to wire EDM or machine the parts in order to remove them from your supports, saving countless hours of time and also not introducing any residual stresses into the parts with those other operations. So with Metal X, really Markforged has tried to set a new bar for metal, but also incredible surface finish. So this is important because highly repeatable extrusion, which is visible as great surface finish, is the key to our dimensional accuracy and parts that fit perfectly in your application. This ball joint, for example, this is printed in two separate parts on two separate machines, and they screw together. It's 17-4 and 17-4, and we just simply use a dab of lapping compound to prevent galling. And anyone can print large threads, but only Markforged has the accuracy to print small threads. So sometimes you just need metal because you need metal parts. When your application requires isotropic strength, high temperature resistance, think about injection molds, and the hardest surfaces, you're gonna wanna print with metal. At Markforged, we print our own demo parts that we send to customers and partners all over the world. We make more than 11,000 of these ball joints every month on a fleet of 30 printers managed by one operator who's not a trained engineer. And we've been mass producing these ball joints for samples. Each part of the ball joint takes a half an hour to print, and the total cost is about $1.50. And we have been able to do this because we developed a process called ADAM, or Atomic Diffusion Additive Manufacturing. The ADAM process is based on a proven 40-year-old metal technique known as metal injection molding, or MIM for short. So iPhone parts, hip inserts, FAA flight hardware are all made with MIM every day. So let's talk a little bit about the ADAM process overview. So with ADAM, you'll still design your part in CAD like you normally would. You're going to export that out as an STL, and you're going to import that STL into Markforged Eiger software. In Eiger, the part is automatically scaled to compensate for the shrinkage based on the material, metal material that was selected. Because we take care of the shrinkage compensation, you can print your part to your nominal or pre-machined dimensions. And if you, especially important if you want to do any machining of features after the part's out of the sinter. So once the part is saved, it'll actually slice the part. And Then the part will be ready to print. You simply click print to send it to your metal 3D printer. So the printing process melts a filament composed of metal powder bound inside a binder composed of wax and polymer and prints it through a nozzle layer by layer, much like your traditional FFM process for our composite machines. Once the part's finished, it's referred to as a green state part. And this filament has 96% metal by volume with equal parts wax and polymer to make up that last 4%. So by default, metal prints with a triangular infill. So it's not a solid part per se, but you can print solid metal parts with our system. In the green state, think of the material like dense Play-Doh that sat in the sun. That's the best analogy I have for it. After the part has completed printing, you have a couple options at this state. You can wet sand the surface to expose the infill. You can also use a sanding pad to lightly sand away the lines to give it more of a cast quality finish when it comes out of the center. You can also machine it at this point, but you have to be really gentle with it. You have to use low feeds and speeds and a low vacuum if you're going to put this on a CNC. So it's definitely possible to dial in the tolerances of the part at this stage before it goes to the rest of the process. But from after the printing process, the part is added to a solvent bath in wash one in a process called debinding. The wax is essentially eaten away from the outside in, and you can never overwash a part. This removes the wax component of the binder, and afterwards the part is referred to as a brown state part. So once complete, you then move the part to a drying chamber for about 2 hours, and the part is ready to load into sinter. So the part's placed in Markforged sintering furnace and sintered under a controlled atmosphere environment. And the furnace burns out the plastic component of the binder and sinters the part at 85% of its underlying metal's melt temperature in a process that takes about a day. As the part sinters, it gently shrinks down to your nominal dimensions. As we've already compensated for that shrinkage in software, and you're left with a part that's metal. And this metal part has achieved its nominal dimensions and is either ready to use as is or is ready for post-processing. And the post-processing capabilities are all of the existing tools that you already are set up for. Maybe you have CNC, bead blasting, tumbling. These are metal parts that have 98% of the strength of a wrought part from a mechanical standpoint. So the Metal X technology platform allows customers to meet the demands and deliver products from small quantities to higher throughput quantities and lower cost per part to seamlessly scale from prototypes to production, driving a competitive wedge with additive manufacturing in your industry. But in order to achieve quantities in the 1000s, you would have to have a print farm. The print farm is highly dependent on the print time of the part that you decide to print. Smaller parts, you're going to be able to get a lot more out on a monthly, weekly, monthly, or annual basis. Larger parts, you're still going to be able to hit significant volumes, but it just depends on that geometry. So we have a number of different configurations that you can purchase from Markforged in order to help you hit those ranges of parts and those quantities that you want to be able to deliver on. Kind of give you an example of that. This one part takes 1 day to print. So you can see the quantities that you can achieve with different printer configurations. So the 111 in the first column or the second column represents, you know, one part being printed a day. And so that's with one Metal X, one wash station, and one sinter two. And then you can scale up from there based on, you know, three Metal X's or five Metal X's in order to get the quantities that you want. So this is really where digital transformation starts with additive. And it's starting to matter because we're starting to see where demand planning doesn't matter as much. Production becomes local to consumption with on-demand printing. Logistics are radically simplified, last mile only. New development cycles are dramatically shorter. Hardware innovation has is accelerating and costs are massively reduced. And this ultimately is driving to digital manufacturing. So digital manufacturing is where digital factories will assemble digital inventory. And the digital inventory allows printing parts with a multitudinous array of materials, of the materials that we talked about today, in any shape desired, regardless of complexity, but most importantly, as needed. And based on the search strategies I talked about today, you should be able to find some applications that lend themselves to additive metal manufacturing. And what makes digital inventory transformation so impactful are the benefits that you get with printing in metal. So first, you get intricate parts. So iterative design processes can be prohibitively time and cost intensive, such that manufacturers may actually stop to perform at parts that barely perform at an acceptable level rather than an optimal level. And with traditional casting machining tools and methods, new molds and tooling need to be created with every iteration. Additive manufacturing eliminates this extra cost, time, and labor, and accelerates iteration process that fundamentally matters. The other benefits are one-off parts. So high volume production is typically associated with cost savings, but when products are at the beginning, end, or even far past their saleable lifetime, companies must stock surplus inventory and storage. And additive manufacturing offers the ability to store just the digital design files and print one-off parts quickly and only as needed, where printing on demand saves warehouse space, reduces inventory, and enables rapid prototyping and customization, thereby increasing supply chain efficiency. And internal features are a benefit with metal additive manufacturing. Parts with complex internal features are often impossible to fabricate using conventional subtractive manufacturing methods without segmenting the part into multiple components. And these components may even require unique fabrication methods. So additive manufacturing unlocks this new ability to produce functional internal features such as channels inside a single seamless part. And good design for assembly demands that minimizing the number of parts to eliminate potential sources of error, reducing needs for fasteners, and decreasing production time and cost down the line. So this actuator housing is our last case study to touch on today. And we're trying to showcase the significant advantages of DFAM, cost savings, and lead time reduction. So this part is a Stanley Black & Decker two-hand held post driver. In the field, the part that we're talking about is the part in the center, the blue, red, and the two fasteners. In the field, this part is traditionally manufactured and breaks all the time in the field. And unfortunately, Stanley Black & Decker doesn't have a really reliable and available replacement because of how long the lead time is to get this part manufactured. So, which means that Stanley Black & Decker has to overnight a full new post driver to a field technician, and that's an expensive cost that repeatedly happens. So in order to get around this, we helped with their redesign. So the original actuator housing consisted of four parts: a cast and machine main housing, which is in blue, a laser cut cover plate in red, and two bolts to fasten the housing assembly together. So the infrastructure engineers at Stanley worked with Markforged to redesign the part for Metal X. So instead of a four-part assembly, they redesigned the part as one piece, just without support material, saving manufacturing and engineering time. So we redesigned the part to optimize for DFAM. We took advantage of the overhang angles at 45 degrees, which make up that diamond profile that you can see down in the lower right-hand side. That's for the ball bearings. We also have a teardrop shape profile that will also print without supports. That's on this side of the part. So using those two profiles, we can actually print internal channels without supports, where we can get much more sophisticated and complicated channel development with printing with metal. But once completed, Stanley infrastructure engineers had to develop new tests for the printed part in order to make it fail, because the printed part easily withstood the traditional testing parameters. We also far surpassed the strength requirements with the part in operation and handling under load and compared to the original design. And we significantly achieved a reduction of weight by 53%. So Stanley was pretty impressed. Ultimately, this lended itself to significant decreases in manufacturing time and effort, where they were able to maximize production runs of this part for new products and understand how this part could be a replacement to deliver this to customers using the post driver in the field so they have a replacement part when their original one does break. So with production run model replacements, small quantities don't necessarily get the large benefits from scale with traditional manufacturing because there's multiple machine processes involved. You have added labor for assembly and slow delivery by subcontractors. And with service part replacement, timing is always critical for support and service. And with traditional manufacturing, minimum order quantities are required in order to drive the cost per part down. But with 3D printing, it's not. With the Markforged Metal X and Stanley Black & Decker, we can clearly see how one part can have a significant effect on a company and even just on one product, reducing manufacturing lead times, reducing costs and materials, exceeding metal material strength and properties, and additional cost reduction due to the elimination of carrying inventory and opportunity of that. So this one part for this one project paid for itself within a month. So here are other companies heavily investing in digital manufacturing. And these are the companies that we're working with every day. These are the companies that are actually changing the face of manufacturing as we know it with additive manufacturing. So if you're interested in learning more about Markforged and additive manufacturing, then I suggest you talk with Saratech, you visit the Markforged website. We also have Markforged University. And Markforged University offers free additive topics to review and get you going and understanding about everything there is to know about additive manufacturing. We also have two certification options where you can become a certified additive expert. At headquarters in Boston, you can come for 5 days of training for two people from your company, or we can go on-prem to your location for six or more people of your company. And the benefit of certification is that we provide you with a broad understanding of additive manufacturing in the industry while focusing on how to design best for Markforged. And lastly, to wrap up this presentation, a couple of months ago, Greg Mark, our CEO, introduced a vision about called Blacksmith in regards to Markforged Metal X and X7 3D printers. And Blacksmith is a game changer because ultimately it's going to create a continuous feedback loop to make 3D printed parts more accurate. The intelligent software massively cuts down the waste and acceleration of time to market. So what it's going to do is it's going to analyze your design. It's going to compare it to scan parts that it has, and then it's going to automatically adapt the end-to-end process for you in Eiger, and then it's going to look at your printer's parameters, and it's going to automatically adjust the model to print a perfectly in-spec part with your printer. And then if you want, you have the ability to take that and use that in another printer somewhere else in the world within your organization, and it'll look at that printer's parameters and then automatically build a perfectly in-spec part for that. And all the time it's learning over and over again in this feedback loop on how to build the most perfect part that it can for you every time. So this is a pretty exciting time to be in manufacturing and in additive manufacturing specifically. So with that, I'm going to wrap up. I really appreciate everyone's time today, and please let me know if you have any questions.
Great. So at this time, if you've not done so, please enter your questions in the chat panel, and John will address them in the order they're received. So first question is, if I have an application I'm interested in exploring, who should I reach out to?
So you should really reach out to Saratech for all your questions about applications and materials, and Saratech will involve Markforged as needed.
Great. The next question is, can I buy just the Metal X printer?
because our technology uses the Atom process, you need to purchase the platform, which includes one Metal X, one wash, and either Sinter 1 or Sinter 2. There are also print farm configurations that you could purchase, three or five Metal X's and one wash, and either one or both Sinters. But if you're interested in exploring this further, then I'd say please reach out to Saratech.
Great. The next question is, can the metal materials be heat treated?
Yes. So each metal material data sheet provides that information, and additional information for different heat treat options is available not only there, but also in our Metal X design guide.
And then the final question, can you just remind us of what are the metal materials that can be printed now?
Yeah, so the metal materials right now are 17-4 pH stainless steel. We also have H13 tool steel and A2. D2 is going to be released in September, and there's also another material that's going to be released in September as well. So we'll have five materials that we can print within September.
Awesome. Well, looks like we don't have any other questions, but thank you so much, John, for joining us on this webinar.
You're welcome. Thank you very much for your time, everyone.
Yeah, a recording of this webinar will be available on our YouTube channel shortly. Please follow us on social media to get the latest information on engineering, PLM, and 3D printing technologies. Thank you, and see you on a future webcast.